who's tired of election season? I mean, the election was a couple weeks ago, and this stuff is still dragging out, as it often does, because one side declares victory and the other side says not yet. Well, partisan politics aside, what if we here at the Monitors pick the next president? Someone who wasn't prone to scandal, no skeletons in the closet, and could only respond perfectly in a crisis because that's how they're written. My fellow Americans, it's time for the Monitor's 2020 pick for president. Here are the runners-up first.
Blood's been spilled to afford us this moment. Now, now, now!
He made a split-second decision that he felt protected not only the federal agents at the scene, but the general public as well.
Don't negotiate.
I got a little bag of sand up there now.
Jack, President Kennedy was a white man.
They dyed me this color.
That's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna protect the life of some 200 billion of my fellow citizens. General, you may fire when ready.
Up front, load.
Since we last spoke, the country has voted for a new president.
Trump!
Here we go.
The list of the top 10 candidates for the Monitor's pick for president. Kevin Kline, Dave Kovic. Dave Kovic as Bill Mitchell. Actually, Dave Kovic is impersonating the president, but what's so totally cool is, except for the not-so-minor case of identity theft that Dave is talked into, Dave is a good guy and gets to show us a president that we would only ever see in the movies.
Hi there. What's your name?
David.
Great name. What are you doing over here, David?
Nothing.
Hey, guys, not now, okay? Thanks.
Michael Douglas, Andrew Shepherd, the American president. Michael Douglas as President Shepherd is a widower who falls for a lobbyist, Annette Bening, unfortunately while running for re-election, and public perception is less than favorable. Shepherd doesn't give a crap, and we love him for that.
I've loved two women in my life. I lost one to cancer, and I lost the other because I was so busy keeping my job. I forgot to do my job. Well, that ends right now.
Bill Pullman, Thomas Whitmore, Independence Day. A crisis better than anything else will define your presidential legacy, one would think anyway. What if you're president when there's a literal alien invasion? Such was the case for Bill Pullman's Thomas Whitmore. Fortunately, this young idealistic president has the mental agility to adapt. And by the way, as a former fighter pilot, ideally suited to lead an airstrike against aliens.
Perhaps it's fate that today is the 4th of July, and you will once again be fighting for our freedom. Not from tyranny, oppression, or persecution, but from annihilation. We're fighting for our right to live. To exist.
Harrison Ford, James Marshall, Air Force One. I mean, hey, it's Harrison Ford. Enough said. Almost. But James Marshall is a butt-kicking commander-in-chief. This Notre Dame football fan, former soldier, and husband and father leaps to action against a team of Russian hijackers in arguably the most successful remake of Passenger 57. He fights, he shoots. Gets in a dogfight with a presidential jumbo jet. Han Solo and Indiana Jones have nothing on James Marshall.
Atrocity and terror are not political weapons. And to those who would use them, your day is over. We will never negotiate. We will no longer tolerate, and we will no longer be afraid. It's your turn to be afraid.
Bruce Boxleitner, John J. Sheridan, Babylon 5. First, Captain John Sheridan, commander of Babylon 5, led a war to save the galaxy, a civil war against Earth government, and ascended to president of the Interstellar Alliance, and managed to have done all of that after being dead.
Now, we gave you a promise, and we are bound by that promise, and damn you for asking for it, and damn me for agreeing to it, and damn all of us to hell, because that is exactly where we're going. We talked about peace. You didn't want peace. We talked about cooperation. You didn't want cooperation. You want war. Is that it? You want a war? Well, you've got a war!
Morgan Freeman, President Beck, Deep Impact. With the gravitas that Morgan Freeman brings to any role, President only makes sense, and he played President twice. But in Deep Impact, President Beck is the voice of calm in the face of an ending world.
We honor them with every brick we lay, with every field we sow, with every child we comfort, and then teach to rejoice in what we have been re-given. Our planet, our home. So now, let us begin.
Martin Sheen, Jed Bartlett, The West Wing. With all due respect to all the presidents ever played on television, Martin Sheen's Jed Bartlett remains the most impactful and relatable.
That's the 10-word answer my staff's been looking for 2 weeks. There it is. 10-word answers can kill you in political campaigns. They're the tip of the sword. Here's my question. What are the next 10 words of your answer? Your taxes are too high, so are mine. Give me the next 10 words. How are we going to do it? Give me 10 after that. I'll drop out of the race right now.
Dennis Haysbert, David Palmer, 24. David Palmer, capably played by the skilled Dennis Haysbert, who is now best known as the Allstate guy, made us believe in the possibility of a black president on 24. It's been said that Obama owes his presidency to the depiction of this black president, at least in part.
I'll agree. On one condition. When it's over, if I'm supported, you tender your resignation as the vice president of this country.
Mary McDonnell, Laura Roslin, Battlestar Galactica. Former Secretary of Education Laura Roslin is thrust into the role of the most important person of the human race when, through ascension as a result of a Cylon massacre, she becomes president of what remains of the 12 colonies of Caprica and mankind.
No. Not now. Not ever. Do you hear me? I will use every cannon, every bomb, every bullet, every weapon I have down to my own eye teeth to end you. I swear.
Benjamin Walker, Abraham Lincoln, Abraham Lincoln Vampire Hunter. Many people already consider Abraham to be a badass in his own way, but Benjamin Walker makes him a badass vampire hunter. This movie is way better than it should be, and Benjamin Walker is a huge reason for that. And the president is, whoever you pick, put your vote below in the comments. If you might pick someone who we didn't mention in today's segment, that's quite all right. Definitely want to see who you think should be president. Also, I'll weigh in after I read some of your submissions. But that's going to be it for today's episode. Please click that subscribe button to come back for new content, and also give us a like. It doesn't cost you anything and it helps us out. Till next week, be good to yourselves, be good to each other, peace, and we're out. God bless.